Alright, someone, this is the final video. I've been doing a lot of polishing and it's boring stuff, and I'm very OCD about these things, and it wouldn't make for an interesting video and you wouldn't be learning much anyway. So I'm going to do what I did the last two videos, I think, which is just to summarize everything I've done. This map is complete now. It plays. I've removed the old map entirely. Removed all the extra bits and bobs I had floating around. Start from here. Right. So, start location as it stands is in there. You're hidden in shadow behind the crates, etc. You could probably remove the crates if you want to, or just have a small crate there instead of a big one. But it provides a nice little shadow because a city watch guy comes there. Yesterday I went round and put lights on all the lit windows, so it's fairly Christmas tree-ish around the town. It looks quite nice. I will fire up the game in this video so you get to see, have a look for yourself, and then you can choose to change what you don't like, etc. What else? What's new that I didn't do last time? Tidied up the two fake air city areas. Oh yeah, I completed the exit location. So basically there was nothing there. I think I suggested there was, oh, there was a door there. I've removed that door. I made a little alleyway so the player can go through to here. Basically I nicked it from my Elixir map and then just modified it to suit this one. But yeah, the player goes there, and I've did all the objectives and ran out there and Bob's your uncle. Grabbed all of these bits from the canal in the training mission and grabbed these bits or pier posts from as yet unreleased mission for the campaign, for the campaign, Crucible's campaign. Got all the lights working. These weren't working for some reason. I don't know what the hell was going on with them. Added some lights around here. Put little lanterns on these beer tables. Created a skin for that one because it wasn't there. Fixed the skin problem with that. I don't know what the hell. It took me hours to figure out what the hell. And I still don't know what the friggin' hell it was causing that. Under 2.05, they're broken. But under 2.06, they work. I created a new skin to overwrite the existing skin. There might be a typo in the existing skin even under 2.06, so all I really need to do is get an add-in for Notepad++ and compare my skin that I created for this window with the one in 2.06 and see if there's a typo in the 2.06 version. What else? Added a bunch of little lights. There's I don't know how many players will spot this, but you basically can climb up onto one of these fence posts, jump up onto here, jump onto this, jump from that balcony onto this rope, and then jump from there. I think you can reach that coin from there. If not, I think if you get it just right, you can jump up there. Spent a lot of time today tweaking all of these lights so they give you nice little pools of light. Obvious pools of light where you can see the radius. It probably still needs a little bit of tweaking, but it's a lot better than it was when I first placed them. Had problems with this bloody gate. The guard that patrols around here wouldn't patrol through it. Fixed that. Basically I had a vis portal just there and then a one above it. For whatever reason DR didn't like that, so I just put a big single vis portal and made the, let's just double check that I've done that transparent. I did, yeah, because parts of this touch the vis portal face and we don't want that going black when the gate is closed. That gate is locked. That door is locked, as is the front door. Had a little light there. One of the guards looks down there, and you've got a basement to get in, a basement door as opposed to a window to get into down here. It's out of the light, so you're not in direct light, but there's a nice little pool of shadow right there, so you can, the player can pick the lock and get in there. What else? I think you've seen this alleyway already. I've been tweaking. I've added funk emitters to all the outside lights to give them a nice little halo. I even created a custom light for these lights, but it just doesn't work properly. I couldn't get them to work the way I wanted. I'd have to look at some shadow from one of these lights in real life to see if the light texture I created or shader works the way it's supposed to. Right, onto the inside. I've created a absolute, so excuse my French, shitload of textures for these inside modules. Basically, I've created plaster ones that are old plaster that go with the old wood from there. But they're all the nice new skins that I've created for all these interior modules. Some of them pre-exist, like all those ones were there. That one, that's a new one, that's a new one, that's the existing one, that's a new one, that's a new one, new one. Yeah, so basically everything up here. Using all the old textures, or sorry, old textures, the existing textures that TDM had for wallpapers, and I've created skins that we can use them all. So almost every room has a different texture on the walls, which is good. So I use this one for down here for moldy, etc., etc. The servant, that's obviously a spy. That's his readable. I picked that up fairly early on. There's the guard barracks. More capacity than this place has guards, but you can put extra guard in there if you want. But I've already got. I'll get onto the guard patrol routes in a minute. The cook has her own writs. There we go. Let's hide stuff so I can better show you. There we go. So she basically goes to the sink, the cooker, and the wine rack in the pantry. Then I've got another servant here who's actually, in my mind, that's readable that we had in the basement. That's that servant. Basically, he's the spy. So he's a cleaner as well as a general servant. Oh, let's move all of these all to the outside. Now they're all the funk emitters that I placed outside. Right, left that texture because I quite like that one in the hallway. Redid there. Use that new expensive wallpaper for the gambling room. I still haven't finished the flipping the roulette table because those two textures, that texture and so that ring there, the red black is it's appearing black in game, and so is that. So I need to fix them or get somebody to help me fix them. The tavern has been completely spruced up. I've done several detail passes on that, and it's very cozy there now. Got a couple of AI, those two guys there eating, that thief there in the corner who doesn't say anything because he's a thief, driving a drink. Drunkard from your original map placed in there on his own, and then these two AI playing cards. And obviously the barmaid or wench behind here with her key for her cash box, some gold, some loot there. In fact, I flew around inside this map and got, I don't know, 2700 loot and finished the game, and it said there was 3200, so I don't know where the hell you've hidden all the extra loot. Oh, there's a plate there, and there's a symbol there, and there's another. Is there no? There's no. Oh, and there's something there. Oh, yeah, I've missed those. That's obviously where that extra loot was, I'm guessing. Yeah, no, I picked everything from there. I must have forgotten one of the ones in here. Anyway, patrol routes. The wench. A barmaid walks around inside. She has also has her own writs, so she's got four locations that she goes to. One, two, three, four. Yeah, warms herself up by the fireplace. Tends to the two patrons here. Tends to the patrons there. the front guard, or the front door guard, as I like to call him, he walks around, goes to the fireplace there in the main reception or foyer to warm up his hands, then does the same thing again in the fireplace in the gambling room, and then stands in the main hallway between that takes you upstairs and into the tavern. Then we have Rufus on the top floor, who patrols up and down the main hallway, and also had to pick a window that would allow, that would fit in with your storyline. So I've made this window openable, and obviously Rufus patrols that, because obviously there's a thing in Godfrey's journal about open windows, etc. But I've done a double hub thing there as well. So he walks up and down this hallway, and most of the time will go into this room and walk around, but sometimes he spins around and goes back out. So it gives the player a bit of a jump, because he thinks, oh yeah, that guard's just going to walk up and down the hallway, go around the table, aka old thief style, and then go back out again. But no, it's like he can change his mind, which is brilliant. I didn't know what you want to do with the pagan. I've set him up so that he sleeps in the bed for, what is it, a couple of minutes? 2 minutes. Then gets up, goes to the wardrobe, and then goes to the fireplace, warms up, and then goes back to sleep again. So that's up to you. You can change that. Godfrey, or Jeffrey, whatever his name is, he was set to go to sleep, but I felt that that provided no challenge for the player. So at the moment, there's just the fireplace and that candle that is lit. You can set him to sleep if you want, but that makes him very easy to kill. I've moved a couple of things. I think I've got to test that drawer. What's that key for? Oh, the office key, yeah. That drawer, because I've moved the whole dresser on the diagonal, the drawer needs to come out that way, and it was going that way and that way. So hopefully I've got it working so it comes out that way. What's that key for there? That's the bedroom key. Not really needed, but once you break in here. Although, let's just see. Can I pick that door? If I can't. No, we need to make it pickable. Otherwise, how else is the player going to get in there? Oh. To be hardish, or give it a challenge at least, so the player would be, because they'll be sort of lit by there, but they can dart into that bedroom if Rufus comes down the hallway and goes to his patrol route. Right, so that's that fixed. Yeah, that's locked and not pickable. Good. Main light is off. If you want, I can put a pull switch for all the ceiling lights, but at the moment it's just a fireplace and that candle. I've set up the secret switch underneath the desk, and I've put a baffle on the front of the desk so that obviously when these guards or employees come in, they don't see the secret switch under the desk. And then that opens up the secret room with the journal and some more loot. What else? The two rooms, obviously this one is open because it's just a normal guest room. One of the guests are downstairs in the bar. This one is locked but pickable, I believe. Yes, but it's easy, but that has some loot in it. Oh man, I think I've done that on every flipping. Oh, just some of them. Basically, I've cheated when it came to doing the threshold for these bedrooms. Just creating a patch over the floor. Easy life. And then it gets rid of the boundary. It creates a boundary between the two, the rooms. But I've seen drag them up from the ground floor, which is where I originally did them, and then forgot to push them down. Ooh, there's one missing from that room. Oh. Grand, and there's the one for the that one there. I'm going to move it down. And the one for the office is floating as well. Oh, is that them all sorted now? No, that one's floating as well. Oh, interesting. I might have to make this one a little bit bigger just to cover that bit there. Grand. Ooh. Sorted. Well, let's check them all. Yeah, done that one. Yeah, and nope, another floater. Right, new wallpapers. This in-game looks fantastic. But basically I've got two, the skin off those. Is that all of them? Yep. I'm undecided about this green one, but I had to use a different one because we're using the orange one in the, or the yellow one in the tavern. Using the old, very old red texture in there. Then blue one in there, and then a green one in there, and I had to create a. That's a single module. That's a single module. As in, I didn't have to create them. Spring Hill already created those, but then I just created little patches, and then lined the textures up and did the same thing there and there, because basically, if I use the modules, you get. I wanted to create two different use two different textures. You know, blue one in there and green one in there, so green room, blue room, red room, happy days. There's the toilet for this floor for the guests in those two rooms, and obviously the pagan that's in the large double room. What else? Yeah, the servant that goes into the kitchen and the gambling room also comes up here to check the status, you know, make sure this table is set, etc. So it gives basically an AI going up and down those stairs. Built a little spacer just there because it was looking a bit daft that there was a big gap between the edge of the banister and the wall. What else? Basement. Let's have a look at the basement. Obviously put the same tech drawer downstairs because obviously the Lord doesn't care about the servants. I think you've seen all that already. I don't know which servant that is, but I've gotten another. It's this servant. He goes between. Let's move that down. I don't know what we'll call him. Basement servant. You can change his patrol route as well if you want. But he basically just monitors the generator in the basement. Well, he does in the his off hours, I guess. He goes to sleep for 2 minutes, gets up, goes over here. So it just gives the player, you know, it's not like a free ride to get down here. I suppose what you could do, is have another guard that goes, say, to the back door that comes down here patrols, warms his hands up by the fire up here, and then goes up to the back door here, stands outside for a bit, says hello to the guard out here, and then goes back downstairs again. That would just give the obviously an AI patrolling up and down here as well, which is probably a good idea. The key for the back door sits in this little jar. That door is pickable from the outside, so the player, it's another way the player can get into the building. So the player has got two ways. The back door is locked, the front door is locked. The front door guard can open the front door. You probably want to make him open. I haven't done it though, but do the cannon lock back door. Also, the guard that patrols the backyard guard, maybe have it set. I think he can't at the moment open the back door, but he probably needs to be. Also, get him to be able to open the front door, I think. I haven't done all of that. And then the downstairs guard, or the basement guard, let's call him, that patrols between here and the barracks and the back door. Get it so that he has, that he can open up the basement door as well, I think. It's probably a good idea. Maybe, in fact, all the guards probably should be able to open all the doors-ish. I don't know. It's up to you, your map. Can she open? She probably needs to be able to open up the back door, I would have thought. Oh yes, I have sent a front door and a back door. Right. I'll let you place that basement guard. There's some patrolling issues in here, because it's so closed in. You could probably change the seat, the position that he, sit down angle 90 degrees. So I suppose if I spun him round by 90 degrees, we can make him 80, but I'll leave you to tweak that. As it is at the moment, he stays there when he stands up. We can't patrol out of there. So you probably want to move him from there to about there. But I'll leave that up to you. Right, well, that's it, mate. I've pretty much done everything I can do on this map. The only other thing, if you want to, I could create some roof skins for all of these roofs, so they all have different roof colours. It's something that I've probably has been meaning to do, but has not gotten around to, or has left it up to the mapper to do, but it's easy enough. Like I say, I created a shed load of skins for all those internal modules, so yeah, it's not going to be too hard to create some skins for the for the roof modules. Right, I'm gonna, what are we up to now? 23 minutes. Let's do a D-map and a map, and then the map is all yours, fella. There's where all the extra skins are that I created. There's some extra textures. I don't know if I have anything. We could probably get rid of the prefabs folder. You know what? I'll leave it in there so you can play around with those if you want. They're the exact thing I'm able to do is I've created a little exec file in my dark mod folder. That's all it is. Dmap, map, no target, no clip, so that I can basically troubleshoot the map quite quickly. Right, it shouldn't take too long. Should be able to get this map under half an hour, I would have thought. This video under half an hour. Good guy. Go tired. Right, there we go. So there's your little hidey hole. As you can see, there's some shadows are being provided by those crates. I'm running under 2.06, by the way. I've turned the shadows off because they're still a bit glitchy and it's still being 2.06 is still being tested. But basically, yeah, the player's got to get out from here and then get to a place of shadow. Now, this light looks like it provides, you know, it's too bright, but I've made sure that it doesn't extend all the way to the floor, so it's high up, so it just lights up that area. So if you stand, it lights, but if you crouch down, so it provides an alternative way of looking at pools of light. I've changed the guard the patrols along the street here because we've now got a street section to City Watch. Same thing for that light up there. Oh, that's a floating decal, you'll have to fix that. You'll have to hug this wall to get past the guard when he's because he stands there in front of that gate. Oh, I know what's happening there. The LOD distance, height distance on some of these modules is a bit too small, so I'll have to fix that in beta testing when you've got a bunch of people to play the map. So there's the back door. I'm thinking of a way to try and let the player get up here, but maybe we shouldn't. Maybe we just let the player visually see, ooh, there's somewhere back there, potentially, that they need to get to. Or make it so that it's really hard to get up there. I don't know how we do it though. Let's have a look. Let's go up here. Think of something. We can think of something after the fact. So the whole idea of having him stop and look there as he's looking down that alleyway. So if you happen to run up while he's stood there, yeah, you're caught. I've made these. These are from the prologue mission or a new job. Changed the texture on them so it's bit vivid and it matches the shape of the light and that they move. So if the player is waiting for the guards to walk past, it gives them something to look at. You probably want to give your inn a name so we can create another texture for that sign. Again, it's a bit difficult to get through here, another little choke point as it were. So you have to be careful when you're walking along there. Always look at your light, Gem. I might have to tweak that light. So now here, the only option you've got is you're illuminated for a bit. I've made these things all non-solid and just placed the no-draw solid brush there. It just makes walking over these things so much easier. Oh, looks like that. Bar that bucket has a skin problem. You probably want to remove the skin from it. And then obviously we've got down here. That light. Now I placed a bounce light just here, but it's a bit too to show that pipework. But it's a bit too bright. And the player is illuminated. What we want is just the front edge of that pipe to be illuminated. So I can fix that after I hand the map back. After you hand the map back. Right, so there's the way in. I might have to get these windows to open the other way. Nice. Now, where's that guard? This gate is unpickable. And for some reason, my lockpicks have disappeared. You're going to need to put those back. I don't know why. Alright, what's going on there? Ah, oh, that fucking guard. He's going to walk through this door. I bet you anything. Yeah. You might have to tweak the patrol route. I just don't know what his problem is. But why is it... this might be a question for Grey Man. But why did AI insist, when they walk past the door, trying it? Oh, there's a gap there in the module. Where does it need to go? That's that one there. It needs to go back a bit so that we don't see the gap there. There we go. Now, where's he gone? He's supposed to be walking through that gate. Oh, I swear to God. So there's his vantage point. So you can see if you've... he walked away before I had a chance. Now... is he going to do what he's bloody told? Or is he going to try and walk for that flipping door again?
Of course I'm not drunk.
Alright, looks like he's going where he's supposed to. No. He was working, he was able to unlock that door, and now he can't. A gate, I should say. Right, well, that's it, fella. Let's go for a quick run inside the house.
Don't mind me.
I don't know why that flipping AI keeps dropping his pear after he's finished eating it. There's probably a forum conversation or a wiki entry about it. Basically, I've left enough room for the barmaid to be able to walk around and the other AI, although here I think I probably wanted to move that stool under there, that table, so there's a little space here for him. There's no pathfinding there for that guy at all, so he gets stuck when things get alerted. Here, I'll show you. Watch.
Hang on. Hey, we got a thief in here.
He's there, left.
Just hope I don't find you.
I'll help you.
You can't push AI out the way. Look.
You made a big mistake.
Really?
Here.
You're going to the gallows, thief.
Oh.
Yeah, whatever. And this is an empty broom cupboard, which I haven't populated yet, so you probably want to put some stuff in there. I'll help you. It's always hilarious hearing my own voice. Yeah, let's see, this little room has nothing in it. get up on this table here while what's his face, Rufus, if he follows you into this room. For some reason the lockpicks have disappeared. Maybe they only appear on certain difficulty levels, but you'll have to make them appear in all, because otherwise are you going to get into that room? Right, that's it mate, you have a couple of little minor things to fix, but then you can crack on with the beta testing.